Hey, what's up everyone? This evening, what I'm gonna be talking about is a study that was done out of the University of Purdue. And what they saw was that 75% of kids with a learning disability had this specific retained infant reflex. So I'm just gonna quote specifically what they said so I don't misquote it. It said that they found that the STNR was present in 75% of a group with learning disabled children, but it was not present in any of a comparison group of children without a prior history of learning disability. So they found that with the learning disabled group, they found that 75% of them had what was called an STNR, which is a symmetric tonic neck reflex. And then they looked at the comparison and control groups, and none of them had that specific reflex. So they were making a correlation to that. And the person running the study, they developed some exercises that was designed to help get rid of that STNR, and they observed that when the STNR went away, that many of the child's symptoms also went away or improved. So what the STNR is, like I said, it's the symmetric tonic neck reflex. It's an infant reflex. It's a reflex that you have when you're an infant. And if you ever see an infant get on all fours, like right before they start crawling, and they'll get on all fours and they'll start rocking back and forth, that is them developing their STNR. It's preparing them to crawl. It helps the STNR is going to help lift the baby's head and control far distance focusing. So it helps develop low back musculature. So what happens is you want this STNR obviously to help you get ready to crawl and to develop your low back musculature and stuff like that. But then it's supposed to go away at about 6 months of age. And if it doesn't and you hold on to it, then it's a good sign that it didn't develop that proper low back musculature. So they're going to have a very weak core. They're probably going to slouch a lot, and they're going to be uncomfortable very fast because their core musculature fatigues out. And then when their core musculature fatigues out very quickly, they're going to be very uncomfortable, and they're going to start fidgeting around, and they're going to look like they're never comfortable and never sitting still. So when you have this reflex, your head movements cause underlying arm and leg movements. And when that happens, it creates something that's called neuromotor static, and it makes concentration very hard for these kids and learning very difficult. And what that neuromotor static is if they still have this reflex that shouldn't be there anymore, it should have went away at 6 months, but they still have it and they're moving their head around and it's making their arms and legs want to move as well, their brain has to override that with their higher levels of thinking. And then when you start recruiting that part of your brain, there's not as much left to learn and grow and concentrate and stuff like that. So in a school-aged kid, probably the most common thing that you're gonna see with a kid with an STNR is their sitting posture. So when, let's say they're writing, they're gonna look down, and when that happens, their arms are gonna want to bend and they're gonna start getting closer and closer to their writing surface. And they're almost going to be laying on their desk by the time it's all said and done. So they're basically laying on their desk when they're writing, and that's a good sign that they have this STNR, because when they're looking down to write, their arms reflexively want to bend in, and then they start getting closer and closer to the desk, and they're writing pretty soon on their desk, as well as their core is so weak that they're probably tired. I mean, their core is tired of holding them up, and then they start slouching and writing on the desk as well. So what the STNR also does is it's going to help your eyes, and it's going to help converge and diverge your eyes, which is important with reading. You need to be able to diverge and scan the page properly, as well as when you look down at your page to up at the board and then copy it back down and looking at your page and then look back up. When you keep doing that, you're converging and diverging your eyes, and they're not going to be able to do that very efficiently. So what happens is they start falling behind. So just in short, what they found, like I said, this study, I believe, is out of the University of Purdue. They found that the STNR was present in 75% of kids that had a learning disability. So it's absolutely, a core of what we want to do at the office. We want to make sure, that's the biggest part of our exam with all our pediatric patients, is doing a lot of primitive reflex assessment, seeing if they have certain primitive reflexes, and if they do, giving you a plan moving forward to get rid of them. So that's the number one thing that we do with the pediatric patients, is we need to make sure that they don't have these primitive reflexes, because if they do, it causes a lot of issues later on in life. So if you have any questions, or you ever want to call me or find out more, you can either direct message us on our Facebook page, or you can call our office at 402 504-4676. But with that, that's all I have for you this evening. And I will jump back on tomorrow for my next Facebook Live. I'll see you guys later.